Hello friends, welcome to the subject Hydrology and Water Resource Engineering. Today we are going to deal with the introductory part of hydrology, various definitions and terminologies associated with this particular hydrology term. So let us start. I am Professor Deepak Narayan Paithankar. I am going to deal this particular subject in detail with all of you. So let's have a healthy conversation ahead and let us enjoy the subject. So what is the meaning of hydrology? Hydrology means the science of water. It is the science that deals with the occurrence, circulation and distribution of water of the earth and the earth's atmosphere. As a branch of earth science, it is concerned with the water in streams and lakes, rainfall and snowfall, snow and ice on the land and water occurring below the earth's surface in the pores of the soil and rocks. In a general sense, hydrology is a very broad subject of an interdisciplinary nature, drawing support from allied sciences such as meteorology, geology, statistics, chemistry, physics and fluid mechanics. Which are the applications of hydrology? In a general sense, engineering hydrology deals with the estimation of water resources, the study of processes such as precipitation, runoff, evapotranspiration and their interaction, and the study of problems such as floods and droughts and strategies to combat them. So it is a general overview of the applications of hydrology. Basically, this is a wide subject which is having numerous applications which we have to see later in detail. Some of the applications associated with engineering are enlisted like this. Hydrology finds its greatest application in the design and operation of water resources engineering projects such as those for irrigation, water supply, flood control, water power and navigation. In all these projects, hydrological investigations for the proper assessment of the following factors are necessary. First is the capacity of storage structures as reservoirs, the magnitude of flood flows to enable safe disposal of the excess flow, the minimum flow and quantity of flow available at various seasons, the interaction of the flood wave and hydraulic structures such as levees, reservoirs, barrages and bridges. The hydrological study of a project should necessarily precede structural and other detailed design studies. It involves the collection of relevant data and analysis of the data by applying the principle and theories of hydrology to seek solution to the practical problems. So in a general sense, we have to see in nutshell the basic science behind the hydrology and further its application to the civil engineering, precisely in the structures related with the irrigation, water supply, flood control, water power, navigation, etc. Basically, hydrology starts with the hydrologic cycle. Popularly, it is known as a water cycle. So let us understand what is meant by this hydrologic cycle or water cycle. Water occurs on the earth in its three states, that is liquid, solid and gaseous, and in various degrees of motion. Evaporation of water from water bodies such as oceans and lakes, formation and movement of clouds, rain and snowfall, stream flow and groundwater movement are some examples of the dynamic aspects of water. The various aspects of water related to earth can be explained in terms of a cycle known as hydrologic cycle or water cycle. So let us understand the hydrologic cycle. This is a schematic diagram. In many of the books you will find more or less a typical diagram like this, which involves various parameters like precipitation, raindrop evaporation, interception, transpiration, evaporation from land, evaporation from water bodies, surface runoff, infiltration, groundwater, deep percolation, etc. If you look at the figure carefully, you will find that it is a continuous cycle from ancient times. Since when the water is present on the earth, this cycle is being continued and still it is continuing. And because of this particular cycle, we are receiving the precipitation, which we generally call as rainfall. The precipitation which occurs on the earth, some part of the precipitation infiltrates into the ground, some part of the precipitation again goes back to the atmosphere, some part of the precipitation which accumulates to the streams and goes to the ocean, it again evaporates, and further the after cloud formation the condensation process happens depending upon the climatic weather conditions, and further these clouds comes together to form the precipitation. So in a nutshell, it is a continuous cycle, and we are able to see the water on earth just because of this particular hydrologic cycle. Though it is simple to understand, but it has numerous components which needs a precise kin study so that we can estimate various storage capacities of dams. We can forecast the flood problems, etc., that we are going to see later. In continuation of the hydrologic cycle, some of the points enlisted I am going to elaborate. Above figure is a schematic representation of the hydrologic cycle, which is popularly known as water cycle. A convenient starting point to describe the cycle is in the oceans. Water in the oceans evaporates due to the heat energy provided by the solar radiation. The water vapors moves upwards and forms clouds, while much of the clouds condense and fall back to the oceans as rain. A part of the clouds is driven to the land areas by winds. There they condense and precipitate onto the land mass as rain, snow, hail, sleet, etc. All these are the types of precipitation which we are going to study later. A part of the precipitation may evaporate back to the atmosphere even while falling. Another part may be intercepted by vegetation, structures and other such surface modifications, from which it may be either evaporated back to the atmosphere or move down to the ground surface. A portion of water that reaches the ground enters the earth's surface through infiltration, enhances the moisture content of the soil and reaches the groundwater body. Vegetation sends a portion of the water from under the ground surface back to the atmosphere through the process which is called as transpiration. The precipitation reaching the ground surface after meeting the needs of infiltration and evaporation moves down the natural slope over the surface and through a network of gullies, streams and rivers to reach the oceans. The groundwater may come to the surface through springs and other outlets after spending a considerably longer time than the surface flow. The portion of the precipitation which by a variety of paths above and below the surface of earth reaches the stream channel is called runoff. Once it enters a stream channel, runoff becomes stream flow. The sequence of events as above is a simplistic picture of a very complex cycle that has been taking place since the formation of the earth, as already I have told you. It is seen that the hydrologic cycle is a very fast and complicated cycle in which there are a large number of paths of varying time scales. Further, it is a continuous recirculating cycle in the sense that in the sense that there is neither a beginning nor end of or a pause. Each path of the hydrologic cycle involves one or more of the following aspects. First is transportation of water, second is temporary storage, and third is a change of state. For example, the process of rainfall has the change of state and a transportation, and groundwater path has storage and transportation aspects. The main components of the hydrologic cycle can be broadly classified as transportation, that is flow components, and storage components as below. So here is a table which illustrates the transportation component along with the storage component. So transportation component includes precipitation, evaporation, transpiration, infiltration, and runoff, whereas the storage components includes storage on the land surface, which is also known as depression storage, ponds, lakes, reservoirs, etc., soil moisture storage, and groundwater storage. These are the standard references which are being used popularly by me, and these are enlisted in your syllabus also. I kindly request all of you to go to the library or procure the book from your friends and purchase them. If you have any doubt, you can contact me on my email address. Thank you so much for listening. Happy learning.